Good day, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Redneck Lifestyle. Here I want to show you a little bit from South America, Paraguay, Chaco, and the colony Mano. I want to show you, it was very, very dry for a while there. And there I am showing you a field with grass after the rain. How nicely it looks. And then where they brought the cattle onto there. This whole video is more like where the grass is, how that looks like the field before, after. This is more in the beginning. Here you guys can see this is the field afterwards. The cattle on there, so you will see down in this video where they bring the cattle into the corrals, where they're going to be working with the cattle. And this video is going to be a little bit on a longer one. I did not want it, but I have to do it. And then the video is going to be continued. There's another part going to be to this video. But here you guys can see the fields where they had the cattle on it. And guys, if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, please hit the subscribe button, leave us a big fat thumbs up, and share this video if you like. And we are on our way to 1,000 subscribers. Please help us to get there. Share this video and hit the subscribe button. And if you don't know if you're a subscriber, if the subscribe button is red, you have not subscribed. If it is gray, then you have subscribed already. And I say thank you very much for doing that, guys, to help us to grow our channel, that I can show you stuff. And here is the way where they bring the cattle in. You will see the cattle also in a corral where they're going to be working with the cattle. And where they give them the, I think they're giving them the vaccine or something. But this is where I've been growing up. I'm not there. These are people like me and you sending me these videos. They are helping me, and I make the videos, put them together. If you guys have some videos you guys would like me to make, please feel free below this channel. There's my email address. Shoot me an email. Get the contact from me so that you can send me the videos, and I can help you guys to make this a reality, this video. So this video, you're going to see how this whole process works, where they're working and bringing the cattle in, and where the cattle is in the corral, where they're working with it, and the whole 9 yards like that. So yeah, there's some cattle. You see her, she has a little baby. Very protective of her baby, so that it's good to, you know. What I could be and all that I am.
Show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day. Just give me
I figure this song, One Day at a Time, was a very great song. What would go here? I always look forward for one day at a time. Never think about tomorrow. Always think about today and live the day as today. So it's just a little combination what I threw in there. Here is the corrals, what you guys can see, how the corrals are. This is where they load the cattle up onto the trucks and stuff like that. So that you can see it a little bit, how this whole corral, this is where they do their vaccines in that part there on your left. Then they have a scale there also to scale the cattle. I think this is the same thing. They scale it right there, right away. So that they can weigh their cattle to see how heavy they are and stuff like that. So this is a little bit a newer one like that. And that is where the big truck backs on there to load up the cattle. And then bring the cattle away where they do they want to have it. But this is where the cattle was in before. So figure we would show you that little bit how this whole corral works. He's going to be walking around a little bit. Show you guys around a little bit the whole thing. How the whole corral. This is the scale, right?
The older
that's the scale,
I
whatever. It's not the other one. This is the scale where they scale the
cattle.
Before
I think, you only get a minute. Better live while you're in it, cause it's gone in a blink. And the older I get, the truer it is. It's the people you love, not the money and stuff, that makes you rich. And if they found a fountain of youth, I wouldn't drink a drop, and that's the truth. Funny how it feels, I'm just getting to my best years yet. The older I get, the fewer friends I have. But you don't need a lot, and the ones that you got have always got your back. And the older I get, the better I am. And knowing when to give and when to just not give a damn. And if they found a fountain of you, I wouldn't drink a drop, and that's the truth. Funny how it feels, I'm just getting to my best years, yeah. The older I get. I don't mind all the lines from all the times I've laughed and cried. Souvenirs and little signs of the life I've lived. The older I get, the longer I pray. I don't know why, I guess that I got more to say. And the older I get, the more thankful I feel for the life I've had and all the life I'm living still. As soon as folks get money, their head begins to swell. They think they're someone special and they dress so very well. They try to leave impressions as they're flying very high. The death will come for others and somehow pass them by. And they say, call back later, maybe some other time. The boss is very busy, he's on the other line. But when I call up heaven, I always get through. I get to talk to Jesus, he wants to hear from you. They say he's really going places and he's done so well. They say it's even difficult to reach him on his cell. As he climbs that corporate ladder and puts on that plastic smile to chase a fading flower that only lasts a while. And they say, call back later, maybe some other time. The boss is very busy, he's on the other line. But when I call up heaven, I always get through. I get to talk to Jesus, he wants to hear from you. And they say, call back later, maybe some other time. The boss is very busy, he's on the other line. But when I call up heaven, I always get through. I get to talk to Jesus, he wants to hear from you.